Welcome to T2 Documentary Channel. Great Wall of China, it's a wall that extends on the northern and northwest borders of the People's Republic of China, from Qinhuangtao on the Gulf of Bohai Sea or the Yellow Sea within the east to the Gaotai region in Gansu within the west. Another wall was built to the south, and extended from the Beijing area to Handen. The length of the Good Wall of China is 21,019,618 meters. And also the Great Wall of China is one in every of the four most important World Heritage Sites and was chosen together of the new Seven Wonders of the Globe in a World Inquiry in 2007. The Nice Wall of China has become one among the four most important things that has to be seen for visitors and tourists. People from everywhere the planet flock to that each year. The Great Wall of China is an excellent and rare ancient military defense project in human architectural history. It's a logo of the Chinese nation, and not only demonstrated the intelligence of the Chinese ancestors, but also embodied a trial during which they put forth sweat and blood. And it's famous within the world for its ancient history, the greatness of its fortifications, its greatness and strength. The development of the Good Wall of China began during the spring and autumn periods and also the Warring States period over 2,000 years ago. The Great Wall of China is an integrated defense project consisting of defensive walls, watchtowers, strategic corridors, barracks of soldiers, warning towers and other defense installations. This defense project is dominated by an integrated military command system consisting of various levels. Let's take the China shut in the Ming Dynasty as an example. This wall, which starts from the Yalu River within the east and ends at the Jia-Yuguan corridor to the west, contains a total length of 7,000 kilometers. It's divided into 9 military administrative regions, and every region has an executive head to administer them separately and to blame for repairing the wall within the region. It's also chargeable for defense affairs within the area or for assistance to neighboring military areas on its defense affairs in accordance with the order of the Ministry of National Defense. The quantity of soldiers stationed on the enclosed the Ming was about 1 million soldiers. The Great Wall of China crosses different and sophisticated geographical terrain, crossing mountains and cliffs, penetrating the desert, traversing meadows and crossing rivers. Therefore, the architectural structures of the wall are different and strange still, because the wall was inbuilt desert areas with materials fabricated from local stones and a special style of willow because of the scarcity of rocks and bricks. As for the areas of the Yellow Dirt Plateau in northwestern China, the wall was built with compacted earth or unburned bricks, but it's durable and robust, no but the sturdiness of the wall built with rocks and bricks. The wall was inbuilt the Ming Dynasty, often of bricks, rocks, or a mix of bricks and rocks. There's a channel that drains water at the highest of the wall to automatically drain rainwater and protect the wall. Additionally to its military role, the Nice Wall of China has affected China's economic development yet. The direction of the China Wall is sort of a dead ringer for the demarcation between the semi-humid and dry climate in China, and has in effect become a separation between agricultural and nomadic regions. The first parts of the wall were built during the reign of the Turkish rulers Sobio Chungu. The new construction allowed them to guard their kingdom from the attacks of the northern peoples, Mongols and Turks, and one in every of the rulers of the Qin dynasty, Chen Shi Huang, built most parts of the wall, and he was also it feared campaigns that were being waged by nomadic tribes from the northern peoples. After the unification of China by Qin Shi Huang in 221 BC, the pace of building the wall accelerated. The works resulted in 204 BC, after quite 300,000 people participated in it, and therefore the Han 202 BC continued. Then, Sui 589 to 618 AD, construction work. The Ming Dynasty, 1368 to 1644 AD, extended and strengthened the wall, and therefore the parts that were built with mud were replaced by brick structures. The building reached its final length, 6,700 kilometers, and ran parallel to adjacent rivers and formed its curves with the terrain of the mountains and also the hills it crossed. The Good Wall of China was added to the UNESCO World Heritage List in 1987. The wall was built of mud and stones, and its eastern side was covered with bricks. It is 4.6 meters wide to 9.1 meters at its base, an average of 6 meters, and it becomes narrow at the highest 3.7 meters. Its height ranges from 3 to 8 meters. Guard towers totaling 12 meters long are placed approximately every 200 meters. The eastern side of the wall, which extends over some 100 kilometers, is that the best preserved part, while the remainder of the parts remain only minor traces. Despite all the efforts made by the Chinese rulers to end its construction, the wall didn't fulfill its required mission in defending the country against attacks by nomadic peoples or barbarians. Only the invasions of the Qing emperors, who successively were descended from one in all these peoples, allowed the country to urge obviate these threats. If you like the video, click like and subscribe to the channel, and activate the bell button to receive all new.